Hello and welcome to this basic Java tutorial in how to make a fire simulation. And we will do this using many different basic things, a couple of more advanced stuff. But basically we'll go through how to use try and catch, how to use how to convert string to integers. We will make a simple GUI. We'll use like enhanced for loops, two-dimensional arrays, one-dimensional arrays, multiple classes with the public and private stuff. We will use a JPanel, JFrame, paint component. Let's see, some mouse click, mouse drag, and yeah, a lot of for loops, and a simple game timer. That's kinda it. We'll pass a lot of variables around, and hopefully it will not be that hard as it might seem to. So if we look at our finished product, it will look something like this. We'll pass in the fire simulation name, and then we'll pass in some variables for how large we want our fire simulation to be. So let's say, I don't know, 600 times 1000, and then with a 100 milliseconds update time. So here we can see we have a green, which is normal trees, which has a chance on catching on fire. Then we have some darker greens, which is, for example, can be a pine tree, has lower chance on catching on fire. Then we have a gray, which is ash, which comes after the fire. Then we have a red, which is of course the fire. White will be the ground, where trees will spawn. Then we have, for example, a yellow here, which will be a wall that the fire cannot go through. So if we paint a wall like this, oops, let's see, then the fire will not be able to go into that area. It can spawn in that inside there, but it will not be able to like burn into it. Then we have some right clicks, which is water, and when the fire hits the water, the water will disappear and the fire will disappear, if I remember correctly. And you can see here that the fire cannot go through the walls. So that's a basic program. We will also learn how to use like no arguments, use default ones, and use weird arguments that does not make any sense in our case, and then use default ones instead. So let's get starting. We are going to use I'm going to use Sublime Text. I don't like Eclipse and I don't want to use it, so therefore I'm using something else, and you can use whatever editor you want to. So let's get going and get started with our program.